What's up guys, Brad here. In this video, I'm gonna go over sealed and ported subwoofers, the pros and cons and differences of each, and what you might wanna go with depending on what type of content you listen to. Let's get into it. If you're new to the channel, I post home theater and gaming related content, including technical breakdowns, graphics, performance, and audio reviews of video games, as well as videos just like the one you're watching right now. Consider subscribing if you haven't already and hitting that bell notification so you'll never miss out when I upload a new video. Also, I do have some Amazon affiliate links in the description below that I get a small commission from if you click on one and buy anything. This doesn't cost you a dime and helps support the channel. Also, if you enjoy listening to podcasts, check out The Fun Waste of Time. It's a podcast where a group of friends, myself included, get together and talk about video games, TV shows, movies, comic books, basically anything that's considered a fun way to waste your day. If you're interested in checking it out and giving it a listen, I'll leave links in the description below. So one of the common questions that comes up a lot if you're just now getting into home theater or if maybe you're just upgrading your subwoofers is, should I go with a sealed or ported subwoofer? And there's a common misconception that if you mainly listen to music, then just get a sealed subwoofer. It's gonna provide you the best musical experience possible. And if you watch a lot of movies, play video games, watch TV shows, and that's your main source, then go with a ported subwoofer. That's much better for that. And that's unfortunately not the case, and it's not as simple as that. So in this video, I'm gonna go over the pros and cons of both a sealed and a ported subwoofer, and then talk a bit about what you might wanna choose depending on the type of content that you listen to. So let's go ahead and get started with sealed pros. Now, typically you'll hear that sealed subwoofers are more articulate and tighter than ported subwoofers. And that refers to the subwoofer's ability to start and stop on a dime. And that's also called transient response. It's essentially how fast the subwoofer can start and how fast the subwoofer can stop. So a good example of that is if you're listening to a song with a heavy bass line and the bassist is playing those notes up and down the fretboard, a sealed subwoofer will be able to keep up with that, whereas a ported subwoofer might start lagging behind a little bit and start blending some of those notes together, resulting in an overall muddy sound. Now you may hear that sealed subwoofers are more musical than ported subwoofers, and that mainly refers to that stop and start on a dime transient response. Because of that, it can make music sound tighter depending on the type of music. And it really lends itself well to more natural instruments, so like guitar, bass, drums, classical music, and not so well with EDM and techno, but I'll touch on that in the cons. Another pro is it typically has a flatter response over its frequency range, meaning that all the bass in those lower regions will sound even and level instead of kind of overbearing, and maybe you'll have a peak here and a null there. And it's pretty much flat down to its rated frequency range. So 20 hertz to 260 hertz, it will be considerably flat over that. And that really helps out with things like Odyssey room correction. It's much easier to fix little nulls and little peaks than it is these major peaks and nulls. Another pro is that it's more difficult to bottom out a sealed subwoofer, and that basically means playing a signal beyond what the subwoofer is rated for. So if a sub's rated down to 24 hertz and you try to feed it a 14 hertz signal, there's a chance and possibility that it could bottom out, which over time, if that keeps happening, can hurt your subwoofer and reduce its lifespan. Now, thankfully, companies have started putting in filters into their subwoofers that prevent the subs from playing outside of their frequency range, but it's still worth mentioning, especially if you're in the market for one and you may be looking at a used subwoofer that's 10 years old or so, that might not have that feature. And finally, one of the other pros is cabinet size. I recently reviewed the SVS SB1000 subwoofer, and I'll leave a link to that in the card above if you want to check it out, but I was just really surprised at how tiny this box was and how much output it had. Essentially, it's a 12 inch driver in a 13 by 13 box, like a little cube of crazy monstrous bass. And that's really great if space is limited on your floor, and or maybe you have a significant other that doesn't want these big, you know, huge speakers or subwoofers in your, you know, living room or whatnot. And this is much easier to integrate. You could kind of place it anywhere and it doesn't really stick out. And it also is great if you have multiple subs, meaning, you know, you could potentially hide these and put these within the room much easier than you can with a ported subwoofer. Moving on to sealed subwoofer cons, and one of the biggest ones is it just doesn't have that low frequency extension that a ported subwoofer has. So you might have a sealed subwoofer that is rated to go down to 24 Hertz, whereas a ported subwoofer that has the same driver size can go down to 17, 16, 15, or even lower Hertz. And basically that's a lot of subsonic bass that you're missing out on. And a lot of movies, music, and video games have information in those regions. Those are the frequencies that you can really feel more so than hear, especially below 20 Hertz. So that's something to consider if you're after low frequency extension. Another con is a sealed subwoofer will have a harder time filling a big room than a ported subwoofer will. You might need to add multiple subwoofers on the sealed side of things to get the same output level of a single ported subwoofer. And it's really depending on the size of your room. So if you have a big 18 by 20 room or something like that, then it's gonna have a really hard time filling that space like you'd want it to. Another con related to what I just talked about is the amount of power needed to hit the same level of a ported subwoofer in a given room. And so if you have that big room, you might be able to fill it with that big room pressurizing bass, but you're gonna have to really crank the volume knob on the subwoofer and potentially run that amp near maximum, which is probably not good for the longevity of the amp. So you're gonna have to run it harder, and that also means you're gonna have less headroom if you really wanna crank whatever you're listening to up. And finally, one other con is it might not sound particularly good with certain types of music like rap, EDM, techno, basically any type of electronic music that uses a lot of subsonic frequencies, so those frequencies below, you know, 25 Hertz. Moving on to ported subwoofer pros, then obviously the first one right out the gate is low frequency extension. It can really hit those low frequency notes that a sealed subwoofer just can't hit. So we're talking, you know, all the way down to 10 Hertz on some models. And that's really, really deep extension. That's bass you can feel that you can't hear. And it's really, really cool. And a lot of movies, especially like, what's that one with Tom Cruise, Edge of Tomorrow, Live, Die, Repeat. I call it Edge of Tomorrow. I don't call it Live, Die, Repeat. But that has some really, really low bass right in the opening. It's pretty insane. So you just won't get that kind of extension with a sealed subwoofer. Now, obviously, a sealed subwoofer has more output, meaning that you would have to crank the volume less on the amp to get the same output that you would of a sealed subwoofer. And that gives you a lot of headroom if you really, really want to crank your system up and you like to listen to your movies or video games or even music super loud at high SPLs. A ported subwoofer will get you there much easier than a sealed subwoofer. Another pro is because of the low frequency extension, it can be more suited for certain types of music like rap, techno, EDM, stuff like that, that has those really, really low subsonic bass frequencies. There's a lot of songs by like Daft Punk, especially off the Tron Legacy soundtrack, that really dig deep, that you just won't get those notes out of a sealed subwoofer. Another pro is having that room filling bass and room pressurizing bass out of a ported subwoofer, even one that's slightly smaller than a sealed subwoofer. So you might have a sealed subwoofer with a 12-inch driver and a ported subwoofer with a 10-inch driver, and that 10-inch driver can actually pressurize that room and fill it with bass much more easily than a sealed subwoofer. And finally, one last pro is, depending on the room size, you may be able to get away with having a single decent size ported subwoofer, whereas with a sealed configuration, you'd have to add two or more subwoofers to get that same level of output and get that room filling and room pressurizing bass. And even then, you won't be able to hit those really low frequency notes that a ported subwoofer can. Moving on to ported subwoofer cons, and one of them is the articulation and transient response of a ported subwoofer isn't quite as good as a sealed subwoofer. Now, a lot of people might have an issue telling the difference here. It's slight. It's become less and less over the years, like I mentioned earlier, with having, you know, servo-controlled ported subwoofers and things like that. And even SVS has made great strides in getting a ported subwoofer to match closely the transient response of a sealed subwoofer. However, it's still not quite 100% there. And it's really up to you and your ear if you can discern a difference, but it is there and it is worth noting. Now, another con is it is easier to bottom out a ported subwoofer, meaning that playing those frequencies below what the subwoofer is rated can result in bottoming out of the driver, and over time that could damage it and reduce the life of it. And like I said when I was talking about this with the sealed subwoofer, is a lot of companies have filters in place that will prevent it from playing those low notes, but I do think it's worth mentioning because it still can be an issue for some. And finally, one of the biggest cons with a ported subwoofer is just overall size. It's much, much bigger than a sealed subwoofer. And that if we take a look at the SB1000 sealed subwoofer right next to my PB10 ISD ported subwoofer, we can see that my PB10 is quite a bit bigger, even though it has a 10-inch driver compared to the 12-inch driver in the SB1000. So that's something to consider. You know, you're gonna need more floor space. It's gonna stick out more in your area than a sealed subwoofer would. That's just how it's gonna go. And it's something you kind of pay for because you want that low frequency extension, so you need a bigger box. That's just how it works. Now that we've gone over those pros and cons of each subwoofer type, which one should you choose? Well, unfortunately, I can't just say, hey, get this sealed subwoofer, it'll blow you away, or get this ported subwoofer, it'll do exactly what you want it to do. It's not that simple. There are a couple things that can make it simple. One is if you have a really large room, like an 18 by 20 space. Honestly, I would go with a ported subwoofer here, unless you wanted to go with a sealed subwoofer because you're gonna add more down the line. And space is kind of a concern. So honestly, I would go with a ported subwoofer in that situation. You're gonna have more bass, you're gonna have more output from one single sub than you would, you know, one or possibly even two sealed subwoofers. You might need to add more depending on the space and how much you like that bass. Another thing is if you're after low frequency extension and you really want those low frequency notes like 15 hertz, 10 hertz, you know, 12 hertz, you kind of don't have another choice other than to go with a ported subwoofer. A sealed subwoofer will just never get that low unless you add, you know, three or four of them. And even then, you have to deal with trying to integrate them all together, EQing them, and that takes a lot of time, a lot of money, and just a lot of headaches trying to get them all to all play nice together. Now, if what you're after is really tight, articulate bass for music and maybe a two-channel system, then a sealed subwoofer, even in a big space like an 18 by 20 room, will probably suit you just fine. Granted, if all you do is listen to music, or maybe you watch a TV show or two here and there, you'll be okay getting a sealed subwoofer. But at the same time, if you really want that room pressurizing filling bass, you're gonna have to go with a ported subwoofer or multiple sealed subwoofers, which, as I said, you know, will start to add to the cost of the overall package there. Honestly, it really comes down to the type of content you listen to, the room size that you're gonna be putting the subwoofer in, and if you're after those really, really low frequency notes, like 15 hertz to 10 hertz. It's really gonna dictate what subwoofer you get from there. So look at your situation, look at the type of content you wanna use it for, your space limitations, and then make a decision based on those. Also, I definitely recommend buying from a place that has a decent return policy. The last thing you wanna do is spend a lot of money on a ported or sealed subwoofer and then be stuck with it, and it might not actually be what you thought, or it might sound different than you thought it would, and you want to try the other one. Also, SVS will be doing a promo in their outlet store. They're slashing a lot of prices just before Labor Day, and it's basically, you know, whatever stock they have, it's until it runs out. So definitely check that out. I'll leave some links to some products in the description below that I think are worth checking out. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please give it a big thumbs up. It lets me know that you appreciate this type of content. Thank you everyone for watching, and I'll see you in the next one, where I go to the fair with a bunch of my friends and try chewing tobacco for the first time.